Hello everyone and welcome back on BlockGems. On BlockGems we talk about what is going on in the non-fungible tokens space, and today we're going to talk about Trevor Andrew, aka Gucci Ghost, and why I believe that we will see a very interesting price appreciation in the future when it comes to his previous works, in particular the works that have been minted as NFTs late last year, in November last year. So we should talk about two events, or actually two different topics. One is the new exhibition that we will see hopefully pretty soon on March the 3rd on Nifty Gateway, and you will not be able to see this page up until tomorrow on the homepage of Nifty Gateway, but it is already open to visit, open to see, so I will put the link up below in the description. And there are two lineups that we will be able to see very soon. One for the limited editions and the unique pieces, as we can see here, and one other for the open editions. Now, full disclosure, I own some of the works by Trevor Andrews, some of the past works, and I myself have been hoping for a new NFT project, so I've engaged with him directly asking if and when we would have seen a new NFT project, a new NFT drop from his side, as you can see from these tweets. I believe that I'm not the only one betting on this kind of artworks, this kind of collectibles. I want to talk about someone else that is collecting these works, and I also want to discuss why I believe that this could have an interesting impact on the price in the future. So, some of you might know Danny. Danny is one of the most known, famous collectors in the NFT space. So much so that he has also been collaborating in actual artworks, in actual art projects, not just with any artists in the space, but with some of the top artists out there in the NFT landscape. One example is John Urlander, who's a top 10 artist right now on Super Rare. This is one example of a collaboration. And as we can see from his avatar, he is sporting a CryptoPunk here. And this is not just any CryptoPunk, as we will see in a second. First of all, we can see from the blockchain that he owns actually a plethora of CryptoPunks. And this one in particular, as mentioned before, is a very special one. Why? So I made a video about the different attributes and characteristics of CryptoPunks and why they're so hyped and why they're so cool. So if you want to take a look, you can find the link in the card above. But this one in particular, as I was mentioning just now, is a particularly unique one because it's the only one that has seven attributes. So you can imagine how big of a flex it is in the NFT space to show that you are the one that owns this particular CryptoPunk. Now, this collector here recently has been on a shopping spree when it comes to works by Gucci Ghost. So we can look at this one and we can see how many purchases of exactly the same work he has been performing. But not only this one, also Gucci Ghost Aqua Pink, and also, if I'm not mistaken, Pink Silver. Yes. So why this is important? Because it's as if we were seeing the smart money placing their bets on a given set of artworks. And as we can see, this has happened pretty recently. And what is also important is that these purchases have occurred on the secondary market. So this is one reason why I believe that we could see a massive price appreciation. As I always say, none of this is investment advice, but I really want to share with you guys my thoughts and also some of the narratives that are taking place in the space. Another reason that I find interesting is actually based more on a comparison between artists. It is always very, very hard to make comparisons amongst artists, especially in the NFT space, because the space is so new. But I wanted to compare Gucci Ghost with another artist that we are seeing in the space, which is Wisby, who has done two exhibitions. One is Bandalgami, and the other one was Bandalgami, the Camo edition. And the reason why I wanted to make this comparison is that both artists started their productions many years ago, way before there was this explosion of the NFT space. So they're not, so to speak, NFT natives. They have been working in a more traditional environment also before, and they actually are very famous artists outside of the NFT space already. They both have exhibited their works in worldwide renowned museums. Their production started for Gucci Ghost in late 2012, if I'm not mistaken. For Wisby, we're talking about 2011. So more or less the same amount of time in the contemporary art space. Also, what is interesting is that they both engaged in street art and graffiti art. Both of them have this idea of a single iconic representation. In the case of Wisby, we see the Vandalgami. In the case of Gucci Ghost, we see the ghost indeed. So I find some similarities. And for this reason, I wanted to also draw some comparisons, because here in the Wisby case, we see that for the latest exhibition, we saw some pretty decent appreciation in the secondary market, as we can see here when we go and pick on some of the works in the limited editions. But what is also more interesting is that this was, as I mentioned, the last exhibition. But what about the previous one, the one that took place 3.5 months before, which is actually more or less the same amount of time that stands between the two exhibitions in Gucci Ghost? We are seeing that for this lineup here, there is almost no ask, or the asks are very, very, very high. Basically, the collectors are not selling. They just do not want to sell, unless for very, very high prices, in comparison with what was the original listing and the last sold on the secondary market. So I wouldn't be surprised if we would see for the works minted late last year a very, very interesting price appreciation. So with that, I hope that you find value in this video, and that you can use it as a tool to make your own research. If that's the case, please subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. Thank you, and see you in the next video.